Hello, and welcome to another program of Painting with Tali, your art collection. Today we're going to do a fabulous zebra. I always wanted to do one, and today I created the perfect zebra. Well, I'm pretty happy with it. So let's go and continue immediately with our drawing. Okay, I'm looking at my drawing here, my zebra here, and when I designed this zebra, I was looking at all these photographs of zebras. And I have my canvas here, and I know that the beauty of the composition in this painting lies by dividing the center of the canvas, okay? And then we know that the zebra neck is around here. See, I already previously made the zebra design. Now, if you people out there watching, see, I go by my spaces. I'm looking at my canvas, which is the same size canvas as this one, where I have the painting already made, you know. So I'm just kind of like redoing it. Okay, I know I need my zebra head around here. Let me give you the lesson the way you really need the lesson. The zebra head is around here. The zebra neck comes around here. The zebra top part is around here. And then the ear around here. You know, their ears are so beautiful. I've learned about these animals, and I learned a little bit about them when I was looking at a program about horses. And so horses, since they are animals that are going to be preyed on, like predators will go after them, like, you know, tigers or, you know, zebras are the same thing. So they hang around in groups, and they're always spooking each other, like, oh, watch out, there's a lion out there, and stuff like that. So they'd like to do that to each other, so they'll be on their toes. And that's what horses do with each other. I didn't know that, and I'm like, well, that's true. Zebras are like that, too. But the thing about zebras is that they have all these stripes on them, and they use that for survival. Now, there's two different types of zebras. There's ones that have tighter stripes, and then this one has the more open stripes. I like the one with the more open stripes, actually. But this zebra, to me, is like a fashion vogue type of, you know, frou-frou zebra. So, you know, I had to do it because, you know, it's a zebra. It's a Tali zebra, you know. I can't help it, okay? So their ears are like antenna, like parabolic antennas, like satellite dishes, that kind of like go up front, back, up front, you know. And so this one, oh, this little ear here is listening to things out there, and this one is listening to you, to the spectator. That's why I fell in love so much with this zebra. Okay, see how we're designing it, and suddenly her little hair comes up here, and her ear, and her cute eyes. She's a girl zebra, and all the other zebras hate her because she's the best one on the catwalk. She's a mannequin zebra, so you know, pretty girls are always like, always suffering. There's a saying in Spanish, the luck of the ugly ones, the pretty ones desire. Well, maybe the pretty ones are too demanding sometimes. I don't know, maybe they're spoiled by their daddies. Well, anyway, this zebra, we're putting the lines of it. I kept the lines of this zebra kind of simple, you know. And then it has strong lines here, strong lines there. It has a line here. And then, of course, the mane of it, the mane, starts having the stripes. So then here we go. Major stripe there with that zebra. Major stripe here. And a major stripe here. Yeah, that's how they start happening, the stripes. And I'm running out of charcoal. I'm gonna get another charcoal stem here. Hold on a sec. I want you to know that this is canvas board. And it's that very easy to find canvas board. You can find it everywhere. Okay. And of course, the mane has an architectural form that is coming like this, like this, like this. You know, like those Greek hats had that mane on them. I wonder if they copied it from the zebras. I don't know. And here we have a little more line there and a little line here. Anyway, there you have an idea of how I composed the, how, you know, you're composing the picture. I know you guys look at it and say, well, you know, Tali, you can do that, but I can't, but yeah. But this is mostly an entertainment program. And then also, you know, hey, do your drawings too, however they come out. It doesn't really matter because the finest art in the world looks like the most expensive look the most horrible anyway. Okay, so I'm going to be taking this from here, and you know what we do with this? We throw it away. And then we put a really pretty one that I already did before. So there we go. one thing very important, it's the Grombacher Mist and Workable Fix-It Spray, and that's matte. Well, the number is 546. That's because it's the bigger can here. Now, this is the miracle spray, let me tell you. I came back to life after I discovered this. One of my students told me about it. So this is the one that does the miracle with setting it. And then you can put all your washes on there, and you can put a hose on this, and the charcoal will not fall off. And that's what we want to do. All right. So let's begin with coloring. Good. We just
entered in 10 minutes of the show. Do you really need that deep voice today? Let me go on.
Now, okay, some red. Need some red here. One thing here. There is a circle that I want to capture about this zebra. Okay. And all you people out there, the first lucky seven callers, will receive a print. If you want a print of this particular painting, just say zebra. You know, there's the voicemail that comes out at the end of the show. Just say you want a print on the zebra, that you love the zebra, and that Tali is the best painter you've ever seen in your life, okay? And just joking. But I love my fans, all those letters, Max. I keep on doing Norma Desmond. Okay. Okay, you see how I'm with the, you know, I wanted my circle, and then I use my little brush there. Now I can clean a little more with my kneaded rubber eraser. Clean what I want. Okay, everyone cleaned it all off here. Clean what I want there. Okay. I think a little. Tali is the perfectionist. Can we help it? Call me unpredictable. Call me irresponsible. Throwing. Unreliable too. Okay, let's put this here. You know, we can use a little bit of spray on there, but I don't know. I mean, like, I want really not to see much of it. So I'm not gonna put in the spray, and I'm just gonna, you know, brush it so that I have a guideline, honey. Okay, that is what I want, a guideline. Okay, now let me hurry up here. Okay, let me see. Let me get some red. And we're using some crimson. Some crimson and some orange. Well, am I doing okay? Have I blocked my head inside the canvas? Am I okay? Have I been a good boy so far? I have Elena. Elena is right in front of me. She's right here. She's my art director. And she tells me if I'm blocking or not. yeah. So little by little, as I perfected doing the show, you know, we get voluntary help. And We have a lot of fun doing it. So right here, see, we're filling in that yellow, that bright yellow. So as we're filling in the yellow, we're getting that, there's this big, you know, there's this orange kind of sun, and it's the dusky evening of Africa. So I was in my romantic mood with these zebras. I love these zebras. You know, they have all these stripes because they confuse the lions that want to hunt them down. So they're trying to confuse them with the stripes. So the lions like to notice one zebra that is kind of like slower than the rest of them, or maybe a baby zebra that can't run as fast, because that's going to be their meal. So these zebras are always aware, like they're going to be on the dinner plate. You know, they're always aware of that. So that's why they're always spooking each other about, there's the lion, the lion's out there. And so they're kind of, they like to be in groups, and they're in a joint effort. And now, let me see. I'm looking at, okay, and don't, it doesn't matter, it's okay. We're gonna go on, okay, we're doing the back, let me see. I wanna have a 27-minute program here. And I wonder how many minutes I have left here. Okay, I got about 15 minutes left. Okay, because I always need to know. Okay. Now let me see if I can remember any jokes, because before I'm gonna like do a program, I got a whole mess of jokes in my head. All kinds of stuff I wanna talk about. Oh yeah. Limping zebras. Limping zebras, it's when, you know, the lion noticed that a zebra is limping. And they know that zebra's for me. So, as far as human beings going out and meeting each other at, you know, places like bistro or a restaurant or bars or discos or whatever, you notice a limping zebra. A limping zebra is somebody that you starry-eyed. Like, for example, they saw you and they go, ah! And then you notice, oh, so this person thinks I'm attractive. Okay, fine, that's a limping zebra. Now, that's your clue. I mean, that's your cue to go in for the jugular. I mean, just go into the jugular and you'll be fine. Because you see, the person suffers of good taste. And your day is made. Now, that is if you find the person attractive. I cannot be serious. My parents always thought there was something wrong with me. I think that if I didn't have a sense of humor, I would have thrown in the towel a long time ago. But apart from having a sense of humor, I enjoy very much doing these paintings, because actually I have not really been the times that I'm a painter now today in my life, you know, Tali's life as of today.
Okay.
The thing about Tali's life right now is that no, I'm not painting on a 24-hour basis. That has not happened. And the reason why, it's because I'm living here in a state. I'm living in Columbus, Ohio. And in Columbus, Ohio, we do not have actually an art society. I mean, a society of people or people who are into buying art. We have the Ohio Arts Council. We have the Columbus Arts Council and all of that. But that's just giving jobs to a couple of people. That's just giving these nice jobs to a couple of people, and they go to their offices and stuff. And then it's a big tax write-off for the people on the board of director. And because the money doesn't go to the geniuses anyway. The geniuses are making shows. I mean, the geniuses will survive, okay? We don't give wings to a pig. A pig does not need wings. Give it to a swan, give it to an eagle, but a pig does not need wings, okay? Thank you very much. You know, it's either Michelangelo or not. Excuse me, I'm sorry. Anyway, I don't care, so I'm conceited. I'm not conceited, I'm sincere. So what? Think I like living in this lousy world? No, I'm just kidding. Let me go on. Yeah, I mean, it's a very sterile society here. And so in my career as a painter, I got how many minutes left? Okay. In my career as a painter, this has developed for me a couple of blocks away from where I live, this actual public access television, where we've been developing the show, and which I have to be very grateful to the people that surround me. My director, my assistant director, I mean, anybody that has helped me, I'm very grateful to. So my joy is actually, nowadays, is creating this show. I have a lot of fans here in town, and they call up on the voicemail, and they tell me that they like it or that they would like. They sometimes request, one guy requested that I do a leopard, and I will be doing a leopard in today's shooting, because on a 4-hour slot, I do three programs usually. And today I created this zebra, and I had her in my mind. I had her in my mind, and I'm wasting too much time in the background, sweetie. And I better hurry up. Wait, I gotta hurry up. Hold on. Okay, see, difuminar. That is the word in Spanish that I can't remember in English. Soften up. Difuminar. Okay. Difuminar. Just blend it. And that's what we're doing. That's the word, blend it. Okay. We're blending here. Use our little fingers. Use our little fingers. You know, in Pinocchio? Give a little whistle. Okay. Okay.
Give a little whistle. You want that deep voice, don't you?
I know some people call up and they have to criticize me. Okay, now, since I want that zebra to be, like the stripes on that zebra, and I only got about like 8 minutes left, right?
About 8 minutes, is it really?
Really, darling, I only have 8 minutes left and I have to finish this. I had a whole bunch of jokes in my head, and I can't remember any of them. So I want the stripes on that zebra to be kind of purplish, kind of darkish. I'm not using black. Uh-huh. She's a really cutie. She's a cutie. I love her. You know, all the other zebras hate her because she's the only... Because, well, I already said that, huh? Well, I love this zebra. I always wanted to make a zebra. And so I've been looking at some drawings today. Not drawings, some actual photographs of some zebras. So what we're doing is just getting the black part and using this purple type of tonality. Uh-huh. Oh, the other day I'm calling Disney Industries, you know, and I called Burbank, and then I said, you know, I want your address over there in Paris. So they send me out there directly to Paris, and then this guy is bonjour, you know, and it's like, I know French, of course, I know a few words in French, and forget it, no matter how you pronounce French, they will never understand you, and they'll go, what? I mean, I think these people have like secret codes like the dolphins that you can't understand their language, you know, but nobody can ever pronounce French unless it's exactly. Forget it, you know. If I tell them, les paysans ne savent pas leur place, you know what that means? The peasants don't know their place. Okay, I talk to somebody French and ask them, you know, les paysans ne savent pas leur place. And they say, what? And I tell them, the peasants don't know their place. And they say, oh, les paysans ne savent pas leur place. And that's what I was saying. And still, you'll never, ever, ever, never get it right. And it's like, can you imagine being yourself in Paris and you see somebody else strangling each other? Oh, he's just dealing with the language. He's learning French. So I mean, he was giving me the address, and it was Robespierre, 96 Robespierre. You know, so they got a Euro Disney out there. But the only way I'm going to learn French is actually going out there and torturing myself with them. I'm going to strangle a lot of people that can't understand what I'm saying. But you can't learn it at home, or you got to just go out there. You really do.
Okay, I'm being very, very silly and obnoxious, and I want to put on a very serious voice because I know there are people watching the show, and I want you to really know my character here. It's very serious.
Oh! I discovered a cologne. It's Grabazzi. It's by Gendrame. Gendram. It's from West Hollywood. And Gendram or something. It's a cologne. They first came out with that cologne Gendram, and then they came out with another. Then they came out with their second cologne called Grabazzi, and it just knocked me. I mean, I just felt so much in love with this Grabazzi cologne that ever since I've been using this cologne, I never felt lonely again. And the designer of the cologne tells me that Tom Cruise uses it, likes it, uses it a lot, but he doesn't see Tom Cruise as the ideal representative of the cologne. Here I am, but he says Jimmy Smits, he uses it. I don't know. This is a Hispanic guy with a gringo name. You know? I mean, why put these names? It's like Smits. Where do you get Smits? We know that is your artistic name. Excuse me. It's probably name is Rodriguez or something. Well, anyway, it seems like a lot of Hispanic men like this Grabazzi by Gendrame. I cannot remember this Gendrame. My secretary said it was like the French police were called Gendrame or something. Anyway, we're finishing these stripes on this cute little zebra. She's a cutie. I love this zebra. And I think that people will probably like this zebra in their home. I don't know. I wouldn't want a painting. I mean, I wouldn't paint a painting that I wouldn't have in my own home. So why would not, you know, I'm pretty good at this. But it's who you know, honey. It is who you know. Oh, and by the way, you can look into, not the voicemail, but the computer mail. I don't know what the, I don't know nothing about computers, excuse me. I mean, there's somebody putting out computer stuff on, you know, like a website. I don't know. It's dianek.com and this, all that mumbo jumbo hieroglyphics. Just you people who like computers, just look into it, and then you'll see all the galleries that have my artwork. I mean, like, if you want to have one of these, if you want to have a Tali at your home, just tune into the website, and then you'll know where to get one in your area of the wood, on your neck of the woods. Okay, we do not have much time. We gotta get out of here. Tali is right now with a rocket. We must have like 3 minutes. Okay. Okay. We need some shadows. Some shadows here. Some shadows to be doing some shadows. We need some shadows. Need some shadows on that zebra. Okay. Just on that zebra. On that. Okay. 3 minutes! I gotta get out of here!
Gotta go.
Okay. Neil, the zebra's almost done. Okay. All we need is some white!
Wait a minute.
Okay. Zebra is done and, Yes. Zebra was pretty easy to do. Okay, now all we need is some super whites to lighten that up. All right. I'm so happy I need a straitjacket, but when you're an artist, that's the idea. Okay. Uh-huh, see, the white is working now for me. Beautiful. Uh-huh. Now the white is working here. Uh-huh. super white here, super white, a little there, a little here. Now, on the little pupils, okay, looking really cute. She's so adorable, you just want to kiss her. Give a zebra kiss. She'll go, there's this girl, she used to work with me, and she thought she was really pretty and stuff, but when she's, you know, and she was Egyptian, and she was gorgeous, she looked like Nefertiti, just as long as she didn't laugh. As soon as she laughed, she looks like a donkey. I mean, she thought she was really pretty, and she's such a little brat. So if she's watching, sweetie, don't think you're too hot, just don't laugh. She's a little baby, you know, she's like a 17-year-old. I shouldn't be cruel to children. But don't mess with Tali. Oh, Tali has to go now. I gotta sign, but what am I signing with? Hold on, okay, I mean, like, I got a dirty brush, and I can't stand it.
I don't have anything to sign with right now. Excuse me. I had to put a T-L-A-I on here.
Oh, on a T-A-I, what, how do you spell my name? T-A-L-I, okay, fine. Oh, it's already signed, what do you know? T-A-L-I, am I blocking the camera?
No.
All right, Tali 97, and remember, it's always going to be you, the cameras. Well, actually, the cameras, the canvas. You see, I'm so happy to be back. What is it? I'm so excited. I forgot the line. I cannot remember Norma right now. Okay, but anyway, I'm happy. It's just the camera and whatever, and all you wonderful people out there in the dark. No, in the suburbs. This is Tali signing off. Bye. Welcome to another program of Painting with Tali, your art collection. And today we're going to be doing this fabulous, absolutely irresistible peacock. Let me get started right away with the charcoal drawing for you. Okay. Now, I want you to know that I always extend a masking tape onto my charcoal stem. It's just to, so it won't break, so you don't hold it so hard, because they're very brittle. And of course, it's stem, carbonated stem, and this is your canvas board. You find that canvas board everywhere. No problem finding it. Very simple design. You have this volume here, which is the body. And you want to note that you don't want the crest going higher than that. Of course, we have our line dividing the beauty of it, dividing two spaces. You know, Renaissance, when you're painting, you know, when you go to the museums and you see a piece of crap on the wall and it's thousands and billions of dollars and you don't know why the hell why? Okay, because beauty is discriminated. You know how they see like a beautiful person that's perfect, so they call the person dumb, a bimbo or something? You know, they do the same thing in art nowadays. It's very industrial to underestimate beauty. So when we didn't have the camera, the television, and images reproduced all kinds of places and everywhere, well, a good composition is a good composition, okay? I compose very well as an artist. There's one thing I know how to do is beautiful pictures. I can't help it, I'm conceited. It's not that I'm conceited, I'm sincere. Because if you got $1 million in the bank, you act like it. But I don't have $1 million in the bank. I have other resources, you know. Your wealth is, you know, I have a gift. And I know, okay, I'm not arguing, okay? I'm conceited. I'm arrogant and conceited. I don't have to say I'm sorry for it. Okay, so what? I mean, in this career, believe me, in this career as a painter, as an artist, you don't get anywhere with this corporate kind of idea, oh, everything is hunky-dory and it's really fine and wonderful, yes. You know, because, no, it isn't. They were interviewing, they have an art festival here in this town. I'm coming from Columbus, Ohio. I live in Columbus, Ohio. I feel like Dracula has been in its coffin, but I've been busy and I'm finally gonna get out and see the light, or maybe the moonlight, I don't know. But I've been pretty busy with this show in my career as an artist, and it's being, of course, seen, my Spanish version is being seen in Dade County, Miami, and it's been very, very successful. I've gotten a lot of calls from the Hispanic community. Everybody, you know, in Miami, I have a lot of friends in showbiz and whatever, but this half career in showbiz and half career in fine art, I have a big body of work, however you want to call it. I really don't care, I mean, if I sell it or not. I just wanted to do that work. You know, I just wanted to create that work. I don't paint for money. Now I do commission work, but I'm so happy to be here with you, sharing this with you. Because your artists, the artists of your community, are the ones that share with you humanity. Humanity is brought in by the arts. Because everything that's in a corporate world is only for money. More parking lots, you know. And we don't need that. That's mediocrity. You don't need to live with that. So your TV monitor now is offering you some humanity here. And a peace of mind that comes from somebody whose kingdom is not of this world is pretty handy at times when you're looking at that TV monitor, you know? But here we go with the design. I loved this design. I always wanted to do a peacock. I just did a zebra not too long ago. Today I wanted to get in three shows in a four-hour slot session that wasn't possible. It wasn't possible to do that. So two good shows is fine, and then your little loopies, 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 and you do your loopies, loopies, loopies. Okay. So the peacock has loopies around here and loopies around here, and then it has these areas here where they have the under feather. So basically, see how I composed it?
Wait a minute. I got a feeling you need that deep voice again. As you can see, we're going to continue with the drawing.
And put some flowers here. Okay. So there. That's it. Just practice. You know, what do you do with this? We throw it away and we get a nice one that's already made. All right. So here we go. Here I go again. I'm hearing trumpets blow again.
All right.
All aglow again, taking a chance on love. All right, all right. Okay. You know, today I'm preparing myself to bring all this stuff to the show to get this together. I even have an inventory list. But I don't know what happened. A lot of things are missing. I mean, it's like we're going to have open heart surgery, and then instead of having a bisturi, we have a wrench. So we got to do it with a wrench. All right, the background. Bisturi, exacto knife. I don't know what they call it. All my high lingo, college high lingo, is in Spanish. Now, my brother, who studied college here in the U.S., his high lingo is in English. I mean, you should hear this guy corporate talk. I mean, like, what did you say? What is that word? Oh, my God. And he doesn't want to be my agent. Can you believe this thing? Well, since we were little babies, my parents would always compare, why don't you paint like your, like Tali? Why don't you read like Wolfgang? Tali, we're comparing us all the time. I'm telling you, the most stupid people have kids. I'm telling you. Oh, I'm glad I don't have a kid. You know, if I had a kid, the opposite of me would, should I say this? Well, maybe I shouldn't say this, but I'm always feeling divine. So if I have a kid, it might be the opposite. So I don't know. I mean, I'm not going to push it here. I mean, if you have a kid, it's because the biology was within your happiness, you know? So if the biology is there and the tulips come up in spring, okay, the tulips came up in spring. Don't push me. We're going with the background. Brainwashing people. You got to reproduce. You know why you have? You know why they want people to reproduce? So you can have enough peasants to keep the kings wealthy. Am I a nasty Tali today? You guys just, well, I don't, you know. Oh, and so they're interviewing like the top artist here in town, and then they're saying that Columbus, Ohio, the artists here are 10 years ahead of their time, and people are coming and galleries are being invested here in Columbus, Ohio. I mean, like, what? I mean, like, this is like the Rockford in this thing, you know, like with the Martians really came and stuff, you know? And I can't believe this. I mean, these people are being interviewed on the radio saying, yes, it's hunky-dory and wonderful. Well, that's the corporate, that is the corporate attitude. Everything is fine, no problem. Mm-mm. You know, I'm sorry. You want to hear a real artist speak, he'll tell you the truth. Columbus, Ohio is not a fruitful place for an artist to survive. In fact, when I was interviewed in CD 101 here in town, I told them that the U.S., the United States of America, is the only place where a frame is more expensive than a painting, than an actual painting, because it's an industrial product. And so you're better off retailing industrial products or doing things in an industrial way to survive. It's a very industrial mentality because some big actress or something is telling you to go buy it at some department store. That's the only way it's going to sell. I mean, the masses, it has to be like, you know, the $1 million hot dog here, come and get it for only $2.99. You know, and that's the problem. They're not used to custom made things. And I love it. I mean, you know, I like the U.S. because the wonderful thing about it is because you have the right to bitch. That is the whole idea behind it. You know, that I'm going to bitch because this is a democracy. We have the right to be happy. The wonderful fathers and who founded the Constitution and all of that. It's just really nice, but it's not a place for the arts. I mean, you're still flipping hamburgers in Manhattan, you know, unless you know the right people or get into the right. But first and foremost about our career in the arts, you do not, what happens as a career in the arts, as in like from, as in like in, it's the public that makes you. The public sees you, the public falls in love with you. And I've seen like in art magazines, I've seen like artists who have made good publicity, a good bang of publicity, have gotten the doors opener or whatever. They keep at it with making a painting to the Queen of England or the President or something. Just, isn't this beautiful? The gods are with me. Oh my God. Oh, the muse is with me. Where is she? It must be Elena. My assistant here is right there. She's telling me 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes. Well, this background is very beautiful. And let me continue with the branch in a brown tone. Now, where was I with the arts? Okay, you know, you really have to do a lot of publicity stunts to get known. You gotta do a lot of that. And one of the wonderful things about the arts is getting into the auction block, either the Sotheby's or the Christie auction block. As soon as you're able to get in there, then we're talking the big leagues here, because suddenly your whatever you did on that canvas, even if it was like chicken scratch or whatever it is, it's gonna be on the block, and some Texas millionaire is with their art consultant, and their art consultant is telling them, buy that one, buy that one. They don't know why the hell. They're just there to make more money or to get their investment go higher or whatever. Yeah, really? Okay, I got about 15 minutes. Yeah, that's about right. So suddenly their investment, there's a guy, there's an artist selling more on the auction block who just began in the auction block, okay, and then the price is okay, and he's rising and rising. And then they start buying because that one, that certain one, has become popular for some reason or the other. But just to get in the auction block is the difficult thing. Enough about art, I'm tired of talking about it. I really don't care to be. What I want to do with my art is just to be happy with what you produce. That's the most important thing about it. Just be happy with what you produce. And there's a lot of learning about it. I mean, we're forced to learn mathematics and trigonometry, which are the weirdest art barks you've ever, you know, like what, and I have to know this, and I have to bust my brain. Well, if they did that with the arts, I think we would have a well-rounded education in people. Maybe they wouldn't go around, you know, doing bad things. I mean, I'm telling you, the arts can only induce peace, tranquility, and it's not forced. We have to torture people to paint. Just as well, you know, they tortured me to play softball, and I didn't want to do it, and the whole team lost because of me. And then I feel bad about it? Thank you very much. I can give it, oh! It got me so, I mean, it's like, no, I don't want to do it. I mean, I would tell them, I'm sick, I have diarrhea, and, you know, something. I would come up with anything. I'm not no jock. I better hurry up. I've been goofing around too much. I got 12 minutes. I heard my director say I have 12 minutes.
Yes.
Okay. So we got this blue here. Now these people at Groundbacher, I want to remind them that I'm going to be needing some paints. My career started with Groundbacher, actually, that paint product. And I'm gonna need some colors, and I'm gonna need their chart in Spanish, their literature in Spanish for my Spanish programs. So, they're gonna be receiving a copy of this tape so that we can get together and use their product line, which I think is pretty good. I've always used it for a long time, all my life. Because there's many, many colors that I usually use, and sometimes they don't come in a set, and they're individual colors, and whatever. Here we go. Okay, the peacock is wonderful right there. Now, okay. Now we know that the big eyes on that peacock, and we must have about 10 minutes left. Yeah, we got 11 minutes left. Tali is going to hurry up here.
I'm not a jock. I don't like football. I like ballet. Give me Swan Lake anytime.
I couldn't help it. My dad would hate it. I mean, I knew everything about ballet, a demi-pied, everything. I wanted to do ballet so badly. Man. And he just couldn't stand it. He was always bitching. Usually when you're, like, if you have a very successful career in the arts, it's because your parents were dedicated to the same thing. Well, my mother, her hobby was bitching. And my dad was criticizing anything I wanted to do. Well, I'm sorry. I mean, and they even put me the same name as my father. And that was like the worst thing that, I mean, it's a beautiful name, but it was the worst thing that could happen for me because I wasn't supposed to live his life. You know? And then they want you to live his life. And I'm sorry. You know? I'm sorry, I can't. I mean, first I started my life popping out of cakes because I was into show. I was into showbiz, and I had a pretty, you know, I had a pretty good looking physique, you know? And I had a lot of fun with it, you know? And I was I always painted. Okay, now we need a darker color. But now I'm more settled down with my art, with my career as an artist. Gee, I don't know what to do with this peacock, actually, darling. I don't know. Am I blocking the camera? Nobody's telling me I've blocked the camera. Am I doing okay? Because I don't even know if I never know when I'm blocking. Have I been okay? Oh, okay.
It's okay. We have people around me helping me. It's okay. I'm not alone here.
Okay. Let me just fill in this other part. I mean, this is kind of getting weird and difficult for me. And, you know, my round brush, I can't find it. I don't know where it went. It's the weirdest thing. Okay. No, perfect. Oh, it goes over the whole painting. Oh, wonderful. Yes, we have discovered it. There's engineering. See, it's engineering all the time. First the yellows were on there. Now the yellows are filtering through. Now the whole thing can go green. Wonderful. It's engineering all the time. It's engineering, you know. If you're going to do devil's food, it's a certain recipe. If you're going to do angel food, it's another one. So you guys, what I like about teaching is that I learn so much along with the students. I haven't seen my students for a while. There's free art lessons at, you got to call in the voicemail for the free art lessons. Okay. And I got to call a whole bunch of people. Oh, and if you want a print, first seven lucky people get a print. If you like this one, the peacock, just specify you want the peacock. Anyway, and then I enjoy my my students because they tell, I discover things with them, and then when I'm explaining them art and how to draw and having to dissect the ways of drawing and seeing, you know, I kind of surprised myself and I said, well, that's pretty neat. I'm a pretty good teacher. So I do enjoy them. Oh, one time they were doing a face. It was so funny. They were doing like a face, you know. It was this beautiful face of the lady in a red hat, you know. And I'm right here. It's very simple. It's like this. It's geometrical. Watch. And a lot of them did these faces that I thought that some of them had been abducted by aliens. They look like some grays. It looked like aliens abductions. It was so funny. It was so strange. Of course, I said that and they cracked up. It was kind of mean, but it was such a good joke. I had to throw it out. Okay. Oh yeah, we got about. I got about 5 minutes. Okay, here we go. We want to. This is the most wonderful way to paint, actually, you know, because you already got your drawing there, and you just go over your charcoal. And your charcoal is set. And oh, to set that charcoal, sweetie, it is with the Grombacher workable mix it spray. I mean, Grombacher. And it's a 546 mist and workable fixative. It sets in the charcoal perfectly where you can paint wonderfully. And it's been a while since I haven't found a spray like this one in my career as a painter, because it's like, you know, when I lost the formula with another product, it was like losing your wife or something, or your spouse. And suddenly I got remarried again. Okay, are we doing okay? I'm just looking at this peacock. I wonder if it's good enough, you know. Okay, it should be nice enough.
All right, back to the serious voice again. I'm really not this way. It's just like when I get drunk, I'm very butch and I want to arm wrestle everybody in the joint. And I usually win.
Okay. Okay. And there we go with the leafy ones here. I should be in trouble by now. Like 4 minutes?
4 minutes. All right.
Yeah, I had a little bit of chili and wine just to, you know, mellow me down. I recommend any wine just as long as if it's not from California. Well, when it comes to wine, I'm not patriotic. I mean, California wines, I've been raised with the best wines on the planet, and California wines just don't fit the bill. 3 minutes. I heard that.
I've heard it.
Yes. Yes, we're trying to get here. Okay. We're in the blues. 3 minutes here. Okay. We're in the blues, accenting more blue into the peacock, accenting a little more because it's dried in there and it's not so exciting so far. Accenting more blues into that peacock. We're accenting that. And actually, you know, I'm out of my, like, super-duper favorite colors, actually. And I'm doing the best I can here. Okay. And here we go. And we got 2 minutes. Okay, see? It's doing okay. In another minute, I'll put the last turquoisey. I never use natural words. I use crazy words. In the last minute, I'll put the turquoisey color. Okay. I'll put the turquoisey color. I'm on a roll now. I get on the roll before I'm gonna leave. Turquoisey color with the blue. I should cry salty tears. Where have I been all these years? Okay. Turquoisey colors. Okay, see the turquoisey brightness on that. And this is the way, what, yeah. Uh-huh. Got 1 minute, gotta get out of here. 1 minute. Tick, tick, tock. Tick, 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 okay. Okay. You know, that is not so bad. I don't have to get a gun and shoot myself, actually. I feel fine. I'm in control, I take deep breaths. Okay. See, my assistant, my art director says, take deep breaths, you know, calm yourself down, you know. I'm just teasing her. Okay. Okay, okay. I need a Tali signature and I am out of here. My director's a nice one. TALI 97. Yes, darlings. I don't want to go. Parting is such sweet sorrow, as Shakespeare has said. Oh boy, do I have to go? Do I really have to go? It's so good. Because remember, darlings, it's just me, the canvas, and all you wonderful people, and not to mention the cameras and the people out there in the suburbs. I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille's. This is Tali, signing off.